Hello, my friend. Thank you for being here today. I wanted to share an experience I had. It was very freeing. I was watching the movie 12 Years a Slave, and while watching it, there was a scene of a slave being whipped. And in an instant, I was no longer watching the movie, and I was seeing a life where I was a slave and experiencing it. And then a moment later, I was seeing another life where I was a master whipping a slave. And in that moment, I realized that this conflict that I've had of being angry about injustice and everything, that I was the injustice and those being having the same thing. And it was a huge relief, like I could let go. I didn't have to fight.
Well, what you're talking about fits so perfectly, no surprise, into what we were just talking about relative to this ongoing becoming that you were all about. Because of course, you've had so many life experiences, you've had so many lives, and in them so much experiences through which you have made choices. And those choices now result in what your knowing is, who you really are, what you are now asking for. We can feel a question erupting all around the room, and so we want to make a very strong clarifying point, because there are those who want each of your life experiences to be a lesson for you. Sort of like, I needed to live the lesson of being a slave, and I needed to live the lesson of being a master. And I wonder if I was a slave before I was a master. Could I really have whipped someone after having been whipped? And you can make yourself crazy with all of that. We would like to say to all of you that you've all had all experiences, and none of it was like a classroom. None of it was orchestrated for you. You just had experiences, all of those experiences where you've come to your individual desires. So this is the most important truth, universal, non-physical knowing, destiny, that we could ever speak into a physical environment. 100% of those that you are interacting with, those who exist as human population of this planet, 100% have had all of those experiences and prefer love. Because there's a tendency to say, well, I've worked it out, and therefore I'm more evolved. We didn't hear you say that, but there is a tendency to say that. And therefore, someone who is right now behaving in an obnoxious way probably still has that lesson to learn. And that's not what's going on.
It's not linear.
Exactly.
It's not linear.
Exactly. But what is going on is that every human who is experiencing life on planet Earth today is in alignment or not in alignment or in some variance in between. And what makes you mean is your discord. What makes you mean is your insecurity. Insecurity is your discord. Insecurity on one end of the stick, security on the other end of the stick. In other words, anytime anyone has activated within them something that is not allowing the whole of them to flow through them, then their behavior in the moment. And there are people who will beat someone today who have never beat anyone before, because the momentum of what's going on and the attention that they're giving to whatever has them so discordant of who they really are that they are flailing about. Their anger is never with someone else. It's always with their maybe not able to verbalize or really understand. It's their awareness of their not being where they innately and deeply understand that they should be. Nothing is worse than to be these evolved, enlightened, pure positive energy, God force beings that every one of you is, and to be in some situation where you have allowed your perspective to grow in a way that you've managed to pinch yourself off completely from all that you are. For a long while, we've said, if you saw someone in the street bleeding, you would most likely do everything you could to help them. But if you see someone in the street behaving badly, your tendency isn't to help them, but sometimes to mock them or to shun them or to punish them in some way. And then you're not satisfied. And the reason that then you use them as your object of attention, I feel terrible because of my observation of you, is because you're using them to separate yourself from who you really are, just like they have used a lot of something to separate themselves from who they really are. And the bottom line is, everyone has the potential in time, maybe not immediately, to get back into the harmony of who you are, because you're not ever going to experience satisfaction unless you are letting all of who you are flow in the conversation that you're having. And if you're letting all of who you are flow in the conversation that you're having, then you're demonstrating wisdom and clarity and love and upliftment. And regardless of how you're being perceived by whoever it is you're talking to, you're not letting whatever they are dissuade you from your alignment with who you really are. And that is true empowerment, and that is true happiness.
Absolutely.
So everything that we're talking about, those of you who have been listening to us for a while know this, is that we are wanting you, in the quiet of your own mind, to practice alignment so that you know what it feels like, and then to tiptoe into situations and see if you can maintain your alignment, so that you can be out in a world that is full of upheaval and not feel that you are at risk, and not be at risk of separating yourself from who you are. To be aligned with who you are and aware of what's going on in the world gives you the power to soothe others. And really, soothing others is all that you are ever about. It's not about locking them up or joining with enough forces to cause coercion in some way or another. The soothing of the human heart into the alignment of their destined alignment with who they really are, that is the work of all, not just teachers, of all, not just uplifters, of all. And if you want to know, if you want to count yourself among those that are maybe otherwise intended, just try being mad at someone for a little while and feel the destruction that it does to you.
Absolutely. Yeah. One and the same, no difference. And that's what that taught me. And even with the whole pipeline and the Native Americans, with watching that, I realized I could see that some of those that are protesting used to be soldiers in the old days, and some that were fighting the protesters used to be the Native Americans, and we're all the same. There is no, it's like a huge release of pressure. Like I dropped half my baggage and I was free. I don't have to be angry at anyone.
Well,
I can choose not to.
You get to be if momentum takes you there.
Right, absolutely.
But at this point of understanding, you'll never be willing to stay there long, because you understand completely what that means. You have disassociated with the behavior of anyone else, and you understand that how you feel is simply about the choice that you are making in the moment. But making that choice then shows in evidence of what manifests. So if you want to know what the vibrational choices you're making, what the harmonic or discordant choices are that you're making, just look around at what's manifesting in your experience, and there are clues.
Absolutely.
Really good.
Thank you.